One thing visitors always want to learn more about are stories of kings and queens. Westminster Abbey is a royal peculiar. That is to say, it's the monarch, not the Archbishop of Canterbury, who's the head of this particular church. And this place has always had a very close connection to royalty since at least the time of William the Conqueror. Our kings and queens have been crowned here. How do you go about crowning a king or a queen? Well, don't ask me. I'm just an old stone head, a corbel, set up high in a rooftop. What you need is a ceremony, a coronation. And the details of the coronation are kept in this book, the Liber Regalis, a sort of user's manual. Coronations are quite detailed affairs, full of Christian symbols and prayers. Where to put the crown, what hand does the orb go into, who carries the sword of state? And then there's the really important bit, the anointing. That's when they pour special holy oil into a golden spoon. The Archbishop then dips his thumb in the oil and draws a cross on the monarch's forehead, hands, and heart. This is the bit that reveals the monarch to be different from us ordinary folk. But what happens when coronations go wrong? Does this book cover that? Well, the answer is no. When something goes wrong at a coronation, the people at that coronation just have to muddle through as best they can. There was no greater muddle than the one that took place at Queen Victoria's coronation. One of the lords toppled over and rolled down the steps. Turns out his name was Lord Rolls. Oh, poor Victoria. She already had to deal with a bishop who had skipped a few pages of the service, declaring the coronation to be finished. Finally, the Archbishop tried forcing a ring onto the wrong finger of the Queen, leaving her in agony. Then there's the coronation of George VI. The crown was dropped. The man in charge of the abbey, the dean, fell down the stairs. Seems to be a recurring theme of coronations. He also handed the sceptre to the wrong person and managed to get the Queen's crown tangled up in someone else's collar. The whole affair took so long, some of the guests fell asleep. Finally, as the peers raised their coronets to shout, "God save the King!" one of them revealed that's where he stashed his chocolates, as they all came tumbling out on the floor. Embarrassing though these incidents might have been, none of them were as dramatic as the events of William the Conqueror's coronation. Fresh from defeating the Anglo-Saxons, the stage was set for a splendid affair on Christmas Day 1066. Now, Christmas can be a stressful affair at the best of times, so having a coronation on the same day probably wasn't such a good idea, though, if the truth be told, the ceremony went quite well. But things took a nasty turn towards the end as the new king stood and people cheered. The guards outside the abbey heard the shouting, panicked, and set fire to the surrounding buildings. Not the best start to the new king's reign.